recorded live at Keeping It Country Farm in Waynesville, Ohio. Welcome to the Traditionally Lynch Show with your host, Richard Lynch, and the Richard Lynch Band.
So this is a real, real treat, and I'm really glad we have so many people to share it with. 30 years as the keyboard man extraordinaire on the Grand Ole Opry, and just an incredible performer. Please welcome Mr. Tim Atwood. And I know you're all here for this absolutely beautiful and funny as the devil lady, 50-year member of the Grand Ole Opry and the queen of country soul. Please welcome Miss Jeannie Seeley.
It is to be here with you, and I hope you were looking forward to us coming as much as we were looking forward to coming up here. Well, okay. Just to let you know, you've got a great reputation down in Tennessee. Everybody says when you get up there, you're going to have a wonderful time. It's a cool place and wonderful people, so I'm glad to hear that. And we hope that you enjoy the show with us. It's funny, people ask me all the time, how do you get an idea for a song? Where, how do you end up writing a song? And I'll tell you the story on this one. My nephew Shane Seeley lives out in Nevada, and he used to ride bulls. And he and a couple of his buddies came to Nashville, and we had a big farmhouse then, so they were hanging out at the farm, and about the third day, we were in this restaurant having lunch, and Shane and his friends came in and said, we just wanted to come and say goodbye, we're heading out. And I said, well, Shane, have you not had a good time? I thought you were going to stay longer. And he said, it really has been nice being with you, but we got to go. We heard they're riding bulls down in Mesquite, and you know how it is when you're a rodeo cowboy. So I hugged him goodbye real quick, and I grabbed the napkin, and I wrote this song that later Merle Haggard recorded, and just last week, Mo Bandy recorded it, thank goodness. We hope you'll like it. He said, it really has been nice being with you. But I'm afraid that I've got to leave. As you know, I'm a rodeo cowboy, and I heard they're riding bulls down in Mesquite. That's the life of a rodeo cowboy, breaking ropes and going broke. That's the life of a rodeo cowboy, and that's the only life I know. On the day you think today is the big one, I'm walking away with all that they own. Then you're lying hurting, hearing someone saying, give him a hand, that's all that cowboy's taking home. That's the life of a rodeo cowboy, breaking ropes and going broke. That's the life of a rodeo cowboy, and that's the only life I know. Yeah. When you're down and you're really feeling sorry, then you go for a drink in some bar. Then someone points at you and you hear them whisper, over there stands a rodeo star. Well, that's the life of a rodeo cowboy, breaking ropes and going broke. That's the life of a rodeo cowboy, and that's the only life I know. That's the life of a rodeo cowboy, and that's the only life I know. Yeah. Thank you. That song was also recorded by Chris LeDoux. And I have to tell you that I met a new friend last night. Some of you are probably familiar with the little donkeys out here. And I met the one named Chris LeDoux. And I had on this lime green warm-up suit. And I think he thought my butt was a green apple. I didn't see that anything that funny about it. You know? I was going to get my pictures made, and I was standing there by the fence posing all pretty and this little nibble, you know. So I turned around and got a little better acquainted with him. Got my attention real quick. But I thought we had something special going on, but he hasn't called. Not the first time I been out with a jackass. I have to... And that is all the truth, you know. I couldn't make that up, could I? How many of y'all are on Facebook and follow us on Facebook? Well, then you saw the pictures, didn't you? And I also want to tell you how proud I am always to share the stage with this young man. We've been friends for over 40 years and worked together at the Grand Ole Opry. And I used to drive all the way across Nashville when he worked a little piano bar because I thought then he should have been one of the biggest stars in our business. But I also admire and respect him for the man he is because he stayed in town, had a good solid job, and raised a wonderful family. They're all grown and it's his turn now. And he is doing so fabulous at what he's doing. He's just one of the greatest musicians, one of the greatest entertainers I've ever had the pleasure of working with, and I've worked with a lot of them. So may I introduce my friend Tim Atwood, everybody.
Thank you. Yeah, I've been so blessed to work with Jeannie and coming out and doing these kind of shows, and everybody here has been fantastic. Everybody's just been so kind, and I thank you for that, for Richard and Donna especially, and I really think this is a great venue, and you're so lucky to have it. But I've been having this big controversy with people. When the football players decided that they would take a knee during the anthem, that kind of got under my skin just a little bit. I feel like if the national anthem's playing, you should be standing. If you're kneeling, you either need to be on both knees and praying or have a broke leg. That's the way I look at it. So I stand for the national anthem, not just for myself, but all those veterans who gave what they gave to be fighting for our freedom. And this is a song called I'll Stand Up and Say So. I heard him say on the radio, they're gonna take the Ten Commandments from the courthouse lawn. And some others say that they have the right to burn our country's flag. The list goes on and on. Guess I'll have to say I'm tired of all this liberality. We need the backbone to stand up and say no. But it'll have to start with me. I'll tell them that I don't agree. Yeah, I'm gonna let them know, 'cause I'll stand up and say so. I'll tell them I believe in the Bible, and what it says is true. And I'm thankful for the one who died for the old red, white, and blue. When they try and take my rights away, I'll proudly stand and tell them no, it ain't gonna happen, 'cause I'll stand up and say so. On every monument in Washington, words are inscribed of God and country, things they weren't ashamed to say. Have you ever thought of the price we pay to defend our country's freedom? They can't take that away. Guess I'll have to say I'm tired of all this liberality. We need the backbone to stand up and say no. But it'll have to start with me. I'll tell them that I don't agree. Yeah, I'm gonna let them know, 'cause I'll stand up and say so. I'll tell them I believe in the Bible, and what it says is true. And I'm thankful for the ones who died for the old red, white, and blue. When they try and take my rights away, I'll proudly stand and tell them no, it ain't gonna happen, 'cause I'll stand up and say so. Tell them I believe in the Bible, what it says is true, and I'm thankful for the ones who died for the old red, white, and blue. When they try and take my rights away, I'll proudly stand and tell them no, it ain't gonna happen, 'cause I'll stand up and say so. Oh, it ain't gonna happen, 'cause I'll stand up and say so.
Tim Atwood, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Awesome performance.
Thank you.
Take a bow. That's wonderful, Tim. Thank you so much. And I am praying this voice will hold on, because I wanted to do this so very bad. Donna and Richard have been so great to us since we've been here. And I know Richard is such a great singer on his own. You all know that. So to be invited up to perform at his farm and at his theater here is just an amazing thing for us. And so we asked him if there was any way we could talk him into doing a song with us. So would you welcome to the stage, his own stage, Richard Lynch, everybody.
Ain't she the bomb?
Oh, I apologize so much. Where's a mic for him? Okay.
That's all right.
Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you guys can see for yourself why they call her the queen of the Grand Ole Opry.
I thank you. I apologize again with the sound of you. I think your guitar player's wife I met earlier sounds just like I do. I don't know what she does for a living, but it's pretty. Pardon me? I see. Okay. All right. Well, we thought about what we could do as a trio here, and I figure there's two things you can never go wrong with: a Merle Haggard song or an Ernest Tubb song. We got any Ernest Tubb fans here tonight? All right. So, Richard, would you do us the honors?
When we dance together, my world's in disguise. It's a fairyland tale that comes true. When you look at me with those stars in your eyes, walls across Texas with you. Waltz across Texas with you in my arms. Waltz across Texas with you. Like a storybook ending, I'm lost in your charms, and I could waltz across Texas with you.
If I may, I am so thankful that I can stay here and perform with one of my all-time heroes, Miss Jeannie Seeley, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
And I want to say one special thing before I get off of here. Today is a special birthday, and Tim's not aware of this, but if you'll grab a G chord, Tim, will y'all help me sing happy birthday to Miss Jeannie?
Yeah, okay.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jeannie. Oh, happy birthday to you. Yeah, happy birthday to you. We love you, Jeannie, and Mr. Tim Atwood. You guys are fantastic.
Thank you, Richard Lenz. One more time. What a great entertainer Richard is. And thank you again for inviting us here. Can't even tell you what a wonderful audience you are. You just are amazing to us. You are so attentive. You listen to us talk even when we don't make any sense. And Tim and I and Roxanne were talking earlier. From the minute we drove in town yesterday, y'all have made us feel so welcome up in this part of the country, and we can't thank Richard and Donna enough. And after the show and after we sign autographs and everything's all over, I'm going out there and give Chris LeDrew just one more chance. A little. Tim Atwood, everybody, my best friend. Thank you so much for being with us, and we do appreciate you, and I hope we can be old friends. Thank you so much.
Miss Jeannie Seeley, y'all. Miss Country Soul, that's who that is.
Are you ready? How about giving up one more time for Miss Jeannie and Tim Atwood? Was that great? Please give it up for Mr. Richard Lynch and the Richard Lynch Band.
Thank you, Randy.
We got American pride. We stand side by side. We talk clear and loud. We're American proud. From California to Maine, our freedom's the same. From the backwoods to big towns, we're American proud. Here's to our truck driving our soldiers in mind.
Soldiers in mind.
They leave no one behind.
No one behind.
To God we keep our heads bowed. We're American proud.
If you get the shirt right off his back.
Hey, all the country music fans are about to beat a mud hole dry to get into the farm out here in Waynesville, Ohio. Join us out here to Keeping It Country Farm. We'll see you out here, folks.
We got American pride.
We got American pride.
We stand side by side.
Side by side.
We talk clear and loud.
We're American.